What's going on, y'all? Sion here again today with another video. Y'all, here's a question I've been asked constantly. Will being frugal make me a millionaire? Okay, y'all, this is my honest answer. No, being frugal will not make you a millionaire. Let me tell you why. Okay. Check this out. Being frugal and conservative, it won't make you a millionaire. You can't save all your money to get $1 million. Yeah, unfortunately. I know some of you thinking, well, I'm just gonna save all my money and it's gonna make life better and I'm gonna save my way to $1 million. No, y'all, saving money doesn't work like that. You cannot save your way to $1 million. You cannot even work your 9 to 5 to save up $1 million. No matter how much they paid, it wouldn't matter how much they paid you. Like, it just wouldn't add up. But what being frugal does, it will allow you to take the money you have and plant the seeds for wealth building. So on the bright side, yeah, you won't become a millionaire just by being frugal alone. So I want to stress that. You're going to have to pretty much take what you have or that what you save up and then use that money to invest. There's so many different methods of investing. You can invest in stocks, bonds, real estate, etc. There's many ways to invest. I'm not going to go too much into investing, but stay tuned. I can post the best content I can dealing with that matter. I do want to let y'all know that saving money only help you if you invest it properly. Over a period of time, your investments will grow. You'll get a return from those investments. And with those returns, you can use that to create multiple sources of income. That's what will make you a millionaire. Like I said, just from the books I've read and the YouTube videos I watch daily about becoming a millionaire, one of the key sources to becoming a millionaire is having multiple sources of income. My take is, save your money so your money can save you. We all gotta work. We all love money. We all spend money. That's perfectly fine. But my goal is to pretty much stress this out. Save your money and then use that money to invest. Like, that's really all I really want to stress about on this whole channel. I know we all have hobbies and sometimes we like to spend more than necessary. There's a time and place for everything. But some people even think that they can just save all their money and become a millionaire. Nah, you won't. What'll usually happen if you save up all your money, it'll just lose its value. Like, so the same money you have sitting in an account for years, it'll just lose its value due to inflation. And you don't want that. So you can stay ahead of inflation. You can put your money in investment vehicles that can grow, so your money just doesn't have to sit in a savings account. You'll never hear of a person who became a millionaire who had money in their savings account alone. It just doesn't work like that. You're gonna have to be different. You can't go where the minority is by following the majority. You're gonna have to follow your own path. For a lot of people, that's not gonna make sense. I know so many people that love to fall in what the crowd does. And to be honest, you're gonna have to be careful with that. It's more of just you just breaking patterns now. The frugal lifestyle is for, it's for anybody that wants to do it. Yeah, I'm not gonna say it can make you a millionaire, but the habits, the practices, and over a period of time, the person you become, that's gonna help mold you into a better person so you can possibly attain those millions of dollars that you want. If you've noticed, you have a lot of millionaires who they living pretty good, you know? And then you got a lot of millionaires who still live within their means. Think about it, y'all. If you were to look up some of the people with millions and billions of dollars, notice their lifestyles. Notice the things they buy. Notice the things they want in life. Like, I remember seeing a meme, it had Jay-Z on it. And Jay-Z was like, he had a whole bunch of gold chains on. gold watches, gold, just gold everywhere. He was all decked out in gold. And it said Jay-Z was worth $100,000 in that meme. But then underneath it had Jay-Z just sweater like this, nothing major. You know, not saying I'm not a millionaire, but he had a sweater on like this, or a long sleeve shirt on like this. And he said he was worth $500 million, I believe it was. I can't remember. If I can find the meme, I'll put it up there. I know I'm saying it wrong, but I'm just saying it to make a point. Like, a lot of the people who are millionaires, their mindset is different. Like I said, you got a lot of people that they want to show off what they have with material things. A lot of people who have the real money, they don't show it off. It's really weird how that works. People like Warren Buffett, this man has billions of dollars, but he stays in the house that he bought back in the 70s, regular modest sized home. But see, that's the thing about society. Society will paint a picture for us to believe, and then it tells us, hey, look, if you were a millionaire, you can do anything you want, whenever you want. You can live frivolously. You ain't got no responsibility. They make it look like, hey, having this $1 million or having these few $1 million or billions of dollars, I can just do whatever. If you want to sustain wealth and be wealthy generationally, you're going to have to know how to spend your money wisely. I like Floyd Mayweather. I think he's a great guy. But the scary part about Floyd Mayweather, he spends a lot of money frivolously just because he has it. Hey, I mean, it's cool. He works hard for his money. It's mad dope. But the sad part about it, there's plenty of people who have been in the same situation as he and lost millions of dollars. Look at Mike Tyson. Lost $500 million. Like, so my whole goal is just to teach this frugal living, is just to show you all, hey, be responsible with money. I would love to teach as many people as I can just to be responsible with the money they have so they can have more. So they can use that money to grow, so they can change their family tree, so they can be the person that changes everything for the people to become. Some of you have kids, some of you already have families, but think about it. After you, they're gonna be another person. And it's like, okay, how can I make this better for that next generation? Because they coming, and that's the way I look at it. So with frugal living, some people say, hey, they just like to be frugal, to save money and then spend it all on bills. No, my whole goal is to tell y'all, save money and then save yourself. Save your money so your money can save you. Y'all, I just wanted to drop that on y'all here right quick. It's just a video talking about, can you be rich by saving your money? The answer is no. Save your money and invest your money and then get into multiple streams of income. That's how I was told you can become a millionaire. If you don't believe me, try it for yourself. I don't know, but from the stories I've read, the people I've read about, they said that's what worked for them. All right, y'all, I just want to drop that on y'all head. I'm going to talk to y'all later. Peace.